Hello all, so welcome back to Dr. Ankit Pharmacology series. So now we will be discussing about in this section of rapid MCQ revision series about antifungal drugs. Okay, so we will be discussing about antifungal drugs. So keeping this thing in mind, let's start with the first question. All are true for the antifungal agents except amphotericin B binds to ergosterol and alters the cell membrane permeability. It's true. Azoles inhibit alpha-sterol demethylase, yes, it is true, and it inhibits the conversion of ergosterol into lanosterol. Now, this statement is false. Remember, it inhibits the conversion of rather opposite lanosterol into ergosterol. Okay? So, the incorrect statement is B. Terbinafine inhibits choline epoxide, true. Caspofungin inhibit beta-1-glucan in cell wall? The answer is true. So let's understand this question. What do we mean by this question? And the answer for this question is B. So let's classify antifungal drug according to their mechanism of action. So these are the five classes of antifungal drugs we have. As we can see the structure of a fungus, we know that a fungus has an outer cell wall which is made up of chitin and beta-glucan. Then it has an inner cell membrane made up of ergosterol. Then it has DNA which synthesizes protein, and certain proteins like microtubule are responsible for cell division. Now the first class of drug we have is cell wall inhibitors. These are known as echinocandins. They end with the word caspofungin, caspofungin, anidulafungin and micafungin. They are intravenous drug, hence they are given for invasive fungal infection. Not for skin infection, invasive fungal infection, which generally occurs in immunocompromised people like HIV patients. Then we have cell membrane inhibitors. Remember, cell membrane is made up of ergosterol. Now the cell membrane is synthesized from a protein known as lipid known as squalene. So first of all, squalene is converted into lanosterol with the help of an enzyme, squalene epoxide, and it is inhibited by allylamines. The drugs are terbinafine, naftifine and butanafine. Then lanosterol gets converted into ergosterol with the help of an enzyme 14-alpha-demethylase. So this 14-alpha-demethylase inhibitors are known as azoles. All these drugs, they will end with the word azole, like ketoconazole, fluconazole. Then lastly, we have a drug which can create a pores on the fully formed ergosterol cell membrane. These drugs are known as polyenes. The drugs are amphotericin B and nystatin, etc. Then we have a drug which inhibits DNA synthesis. How to remember this drug? It is ending with the word cytosine. So it's a fake pyrimidine analog. Hence it will inhibit DNA synthesis. Then we have a very important drug that is microtubule inhibitor. This is griseofulvin. And lastly, we have a topical drug for protein synthesis inhibitor, tavapadol, that I will be telling you it is approved for onychomycosis. So keeping this thing in mind, let's start with the first antifungal drug, that is cell wall inhibitor, echinocandins. So cell wall inhibitors, they are known as echinocandins. Their mechanism of action is they inhibit 1,3-beta-glucan synthase enzyme. Hence they inhibit the synthesis of fungal cell wall which contains beta-glucan. These drugs are intravenous drug. Remember, they are not the drug of choice, they are second line drug as a salvage therapy. That means when there is resistance to first line drug. The drugs are caspofungin, anidulafungin and micafungin. Remember where they are given. Caspofungin is given for candidiasis and aspergillosis C and A, while anidulafungin and micafungin right now have been approved only for candidiasis. Okay, they are fungicidal for candida while fungistatic for aspergillosis. They are also given for prophylaxis in neutropenic patient to prevent fungal infection. The good thing about these drugs are they are non-nephrotoxic, they are renal safe. Amphotericin B, which is the main antifungal drug, I will be telling you, is a nephrotoxic drug. Then we have DNA synthesis inhibitor, that is 5-fluocytosine. Its active form is known as 5-fluorouracil, which inhibits thymidylate synthase enzyme. Hence, uracil will not be converted into thymidine. Now, this drug is an oral drug. It is only given along with amphotericin B because it has a synergistic effect. Amphotericin B will inhibit fungal cell membrane. 5-fluocytosine can enter into the cell easily, and this combination is the drug of choice for the treatment of cryptococcal meningitis. So the treatment of cryptococcal meningitis is 5-fluocytosine with amphotericin B combination. The side effect is it inhibits cell division, it causes bone marrow suppression. Then we have microtubule inhibitor. The drug name is griseofulvin. It's a very important drug. Remember, it is an oral drug which is given for skin infection. The reason is it has a high affinity for the keratin protein which are present on the skin. And fungus on our skin, remember, it feeds on keratin protein. And it is given along with meals because fatty meals increase the absorption and it is a CYP inducer. Now it is given for fungal skin infection, but remember, it is only given for dermatophytosis. Dermatophytosis is also known as tinea. Remember, it is caused by three fungus known as Trichophyton, Mycosporidium and Epidermophyton. Now it is a drug of choice for tinea capitis. Okay, while in other tinea, remember like Pedia, Corporis and Cruris, now the resistance have developed in past 2 years. Now remember, it is not effective for other topical skin infection like Candida. Griseofulvin is not effective in Candida. It is not effective in tinea versicolor, which is caused by Melassezia furfur and onychomycosis. In all these conditions, remember the drug of choice is terfenadine or azoles. The side effect is, okay, so in Candida and tinea versicolor, griseofulvin is not effective. It is written in black. Here the drug of choice we have generally is azoles, terbinafine and amphotericin B. So they are broad spectrum drug which are written in red. This griseofulvin is only given for tinea or dermatophytosis, okay, Trichophyton, Microsporum and Epidermophyton fungal infection, only these. Now the side effect is headache and disulfiram like reaction. Now let's talk about the drugs acting on cell membrane. Cell membrane is made up of ergosterol. So the first molecule is squalene. Squalene gets converted into lanosterol with the help of an enzyme squalene epoxide. This squalene epoxide is inhibited by a drug known as allyl amines. The drugs are terbinafine, naftifine, which I'll be telling you. Then 14-alpha-dimethylase is inhibited by azoles. And fungal cell membrane pores are created by amphotericin B polyenes. So let's talk about the first allyl amines, which inhibit squalene epoxide. They are fungicidal drug. The drugs are terbinafine, naftifine and butanafine. They are given as a 1% cream. It can be given orally. And remember, it is drug of choice for any type of fungal skin infection. Okay, it is effective against all dermatophytes, tinea versicolor caused by Melassezia and Candida. While griseofulvin was not effective for tinea versicolor and Candida, griseofulvin was only effective for dermatophytes. Okay, then we have azoles. Azoles are broad spectrum drug. They are fungicidal. They either, depending upon their structure, they are imidazole or triazole. Now we have a third drug also, that is thiazole, which is right now a new drug, not important for you. Now imidazole, remember, they can be topical or it can be systemic as well. The only imidazole which can be given topically as well as systemically. Systemically means oral or IV is ketoconazole. Similarly, we have triazole. The only triazole which can be given topically is fluconazole, while all other triazoles are systemic. Okay. So ketoconazole and fluconazole, they are given both topically and systemically. So the drugs are written in front of you. The mnemonic is cum lost, topical imidazoles. Systemic, we have VIPI. Okay. Now these are the total overall list of certain other miscellaneous antifungal drug. The mnemonic is Bhutan country. B for benzoic acid with salicylic acid. It is known as Whitfield ointment. Haloperongin, undisilenic acid, tolnaftate, azoles, nystatin and cyclopyroxolamine. So these are the other topical antifungal drugs. Now let's talk about azoles in detail. The first azole which we developed was ketoconazole, but now it has been rarely used. It is taken up by the use of ketoconazole have been taken care by now itraconazole. It is still given as a topical shampoos for seborrheic dermatitis and dandruff. The problem with ketoconazole was it was an enzyme inhibitor. It inhibits steroidal hormone synthesis in all of the body. It is highly hepatotoxic. It causes adrenal failure. And due to testosterone deficiency, which is a steroidal hormone, it causes gynecomastia and impotency. Then we have fluconazole. Fluconazole is the drug of choice for all yeast-like fungi, Candida, cryptococcal meningitis, and coccidioid meningitis. Okay. Now remember, for any serious infection, we generally give amphotericin B. But remember, it is not effective. It is only given for yeast-like fungi. It is not effective for molds and dimorphic. Now the drug of choice for molds is itraconazole. Sorry, dimorphic fungi is itraconazole. So these are the various examples of dimorphic fungi: blastomycosis, histoplasmosis, sporotrichosis, paracoccidioidomycosis, and penicillinosis. Okay. Now it is also the drug of choice for use mycetoma. Now remember, for molds, it is given for prevention. In molds like aspergillosis, cecosporidium, fusarium, and trichosporium sporon, we rather use voriconazole. Okay, it is given for molds, but voriconazole and other azoles, they are not effective against one mold known as mucormycosis. The only azole which is effective against mucormycosis are posaconazole and isavuconazole, but remember the drug of choice is amphotericin B. Now, if you talk about polyenes which create pores on fungal cell membrane, they are broad spectrum fungicidal drug, they are obtained from streptomycin. The drug which is given IV is amphotericin B, it is obtained from Streptomyces nodosus. Then we have certain topical drug like nystatin. It is given for superficial candidiasis like oral thrush. It is obtained from Streptomyces norsi. Natamycin is given for fungal keratomycosis. These fortified amphotericin B and silver nitrate are the other drug which we use for fungal keratomycosis. And hemisys, which is obtained in India, it was developed in India by Streptomyces pimprina. Pimprina is a place in India in Himachal Pradesh, Pimpri. Now, amphotericin B is the mainstay of invasive fungal infection or serious fungal infection. So, it is the drug of choice for all serious fungal infection, except it is not effective in, remember, eumycetoma, alricia, microsporidium and pneumocystis. It is not effective in all these conditions. It is also an anti-protozoal drug. It is also the drug of choice for Kalazar and Nagleria species. Now, the side effect, remember, amphotericin B is always given in dextrose. Okay, in glucose solution. It is never given in normal saline because it precipitates. The side effect of amphotericin B are 4A. It causes allergic reaction. To prevent this allergic reaction, give pre-treatment with NSAID, steroid or antihistaminic. It causes nephrotoxicity or azotemia. It causes loss of all ions. To prevent nephrotoxicity, we give pre-treatment with saline at least 2 liters for 2 hours. It also causes anemia, which is normocytic and hypochromic because of bone marrow suppression. In CSF, when it is given as an intraventricular injection for meningitis, it causes meningeal inflammation known as arachnoiditis during intrathecal injection. So 4A are the side effect. These are the preparations of amphotericin B. The best preparation we have is LAM, that is liposomal amphotericin B, because it has all the side effects which we have discussed till now is least among liposomal amphotericin B. Okay, so this is the best drug, but the problem with this is it is highly costly drug. So this is all about antifungal drug. Keeping this thing in mind, let's solve the questions of now antifungal drugs. Which of the following is not used in Candida? We have already discussed the drug which is not effective in Candida. The only drug which is not effective in Candida was griseofulvin. Okay, now the drugs which are effective against Candida are azoles. They are the drug of choice. Terbinafine. All azoles are given, remember. Terbinafine and polyenes like amphotericin B. Rest all other drugs are given in azoles in Candida. All other drugs except griseofulvin are effective against Candida infection. Here griseofulvin is not given. Answer is none of the above. Even echinocandins were effective. All antifungals are effective against Candida except griseofulvin. Which of the following is not correct match? The first is histoplasmosis. Remember, it's a dimorphic fungi. And for dimorphic fungi, we give itraconazole. It's absolutely true. Aspergillosis, yes, it is a mold. For mold, we give voriconazole. Except which mold? Mucormycosis. Here, the drug of choice is we use posaconazole or isavuconazole, two mold. Only these two drugs are effective. So it is also true. So the answer is all of the following are correct option. Okay. Which of the following is not an antifungal drug? So we have already discussed that mnemonic: ketoconazole, undisilenic acid, cyclopyroxolamine. I again show you that slide of topical antifungals. Okay. So this was the topical antifungal: undisilenic acid, cyclopyroxolamine, all are given out here. So the drug which is not an antifungal is clofazimine. Remember, clofazimine is an anti-leprosy drug. It is anti-leprosy drug and anti-TB drug. All of the following antimicrobial agents are used topically except. The answer is griseofulvin. Remember, griseofulvin is an oral drug for topical fungal infection. Okay. Now, azoles, polyenes, all are given topically. We have already discussed. So griseofulvin is an oral drug for topical fungal infection. Which of the following is caused by amphotericin B? Remember, amphotericin B causes loss of all ions in urine. Loss of all ions. Because it is highly nephrotoxic. So loss of all ions, you will write hypokalemia. It will also cause hypomagnesemia. Okay, so the main answer you will write is hypokalemia out here. This is the main answer. It may also cause hyponatremia, but you will go by the answer hypokalemia. Okay, this is the best answer. Now, which of the following is the treatment of choice for cryptococcal meningitis? I've already told you cryptococcal meningitis, the treatment of choice was 5-fluocytosine along with amphotericin B. This was the treatment of choice for cryptococcal meningitis. Okay, and among them you are finding both options are given 5-fluocytosine and amphotericin B. But remember, the mainstay of treatment is always amphotericin B. Hence, you have to choose an option. You will go by the word amphotericin B. Okay, because it is the most effective drug. Hence, you will go by the answer amphotericin B. Which drug could treat both dermatophytosis and candidal infection? We have already discussed that was Azoles. Okay, the drug was Azoles. So the answer for this question was ketoconazole. So remember, Azoles can treat both skin and candidal infection. Okay, it can. The second drug is terbinafine, which can treat both dermatophytosis and candida, and you can also write amphotericin B also. The drug which cannot treat fungal candidal infection is, which cannot treat candidal infection was griseofulbin. Griseofulbin can only treat dermatophytosis. Which of the following drugs act on cell membrane except? The answer was griseofulbin. Griseofulbin, I told you, was microtubule inhibitor. Okay. Nystatin and amphotericin B are polyenes. They create fungal pores on cell membrane. Polymyxin is also a cell membrane inhibitor, but it is not an antifungal drug. It is rather an antibacterial drug. So that we have already discussed in antibacterials. Okay. Now, antifungal having high affinity for keratin. If the word keratin comes, mark the answer griseofulbin. That is why it is given orally, oral drug for topical skin infection, because it binds to keratin. Okay. Now, griseofulbin is not used in all of the following. That is tinea versicolor. We have already discussed caused by Melassezia furfur. While it is all effective against all types of dermatophytes. Antifungal, which is used orally only, is, so the answer for this question was itraconazole. I have already told you that list of the drug, so I'll again show you that list again. Antifungal, which is only given orally, was itraconazole. So this was the complete list. If you can see systemically, itraconazole is written in pink. Systemically, that means oral and IV. Okay, so systemically itraconazole. Now, true about antifungal drugs is all of the following except ketoconazole inhibit ergosterol synthesis, true, because it inhibit conversion of lanosterol into ergosterol. It's absolutely true. Now, the second question is asking ketoconazole causes adrenal insufficiency. It's absolutely true. It decreases the synthesis of all steroid hormones in the body. Nystatin is used in systemic disease. Now, this is a false statement. Remember, nystatin is only given topical. It is highly toxic drug. It is never given by injection. So the polyenes, which is only given by injection, was amphotericin B. Fluconazole is the drug of choice for candidiasis. It's absolutely true. So the answer is C. Okay. Now, amphotericin B should be administered in glucose solution. Okay. That is 5% dextrose or 10% dextrose solution. It is never administered in any other solution, especially ringer lactate, saline or mannitol, because it becomes precipitated. All of the following antifungal agents, all are true about antifungal agents except. Now, the answer for this question is voriconazole, approximately 30% of the patient note visual changes within 30. But remember, voriconazole side effect is visual disturbance. Okay. So remember this part, V for voriconazole, the side effect is visual disturbance. The first statement is absolutely true. Fluconazole, it has maximum CNS penetration. And again, the answer is absolutely true. Okay, so fluconazole gets maximum secreted in CSF fluid. CSF word is coming, F for fluconazole. And it is the only azole which is eliminated by the kidney. The answer is true. Okay. Now, caspofungin used in invasive aspergillosis. Yes, it is given in invasive aspergillosis as a salvage therapy. The answer is absolutely true. We have discussed who are intolerant to amphotericin B and true. Voriconazole. Now, fluconazole is approved for invasive aspergillosis. Now, this is a false statement. Remember, fluconazole is only given for yeast-like fungi. Like Candida and Coccidiomycosis. Aspergillosis is a mold. Remember, against mold, we rather use voriconazole. Okay? Absorption of which of the following drug increases with food intake? The answer was griseofulvin. So, this antifungal is always given with food, griseofulvin. A diabetic patient presents with fungal infection of sinuses, periorbital region, with significant visual loss. Now remember, there is a fungus known as mucormycosis. Now mucormycosis, remember, is a type of a mold which causes generally ENT infections, mainly malignant otitis externa. Okay. It may cause sinusitis, and it is a very dangerous infection because it can penetrate the intact bone and it can directly cause brain abscess. Now, the drug of choice for the treatment of mucormycosis, and remember, mucormycosis mainly occurs in a diabetic patient. Okay. Now, the treatment of mucormycosis is amphotericin B. This is the drug of choice. Okay. For treatment, for prevention and long-term maintenance, because amphotericin B we don't give in long-term, we give azoles like posaconazole and isavuconazole. So this is the treatment of mucormycosis. Only these two azoles are effective against mucormycosis. Hence the answer is blindly marked the answer amphotericin B. Okay. So the answer is amphotericin B. Now let's move forward. Amphotericin B toxicity can be reduced by injecting the drug with dextrose. No, it is given rather to inhibit precipitation. Inhibited precipitation be compliant. Combining with flucytosine, the answer is no. It is rather a synergistic combination which is given in cases of cryptococcal meningitis. It is rather to increase the effectiveness. Combining with fluconazole, remember, azoles and amphotericin B are absolutely contraindicated. They are never combined. We have already discussed liposomal preparations of amphotericin B was least toxic. Okay, so liposomal preparations are least toxic. That is why we make the liposomal preparation are less toxic. So we incorporate this amphotericin B in a lipid membrane. Okay. So that it should not interfere with other cells. The antimicrobial agent that inhibit ergosterol synthesis is, the answer was azole. Okay, azole. Remember, amphotericin B will create a pore on already formed ergosterol cell membrane. Synthesis is inhibited by azoles. Which of the following statement about fluconazole is most accurate? It is highly effective in aspergillosis. False. Remember, it is only given for yeast-like fungi, it is not effective in mold-like aspergillosis. It does not penetrate blood-brain barrier. False. It is the antifungal drug which has maximum penetration into blood-brain barrier. Among all antifungal drug, it has maximum penetration into blood-brain barrier. Its oral bioavailability is less than ketoconazole. The false. Remember, it is very good absorbed orally. It has maximum oral bioavailability among all azoles. It inhibits demethylation of lanosterol. The answer is true. So it inhibits 14-alpha demethylase. Yes. So it inhibits 14-alpha demethylase. And because of this reason, the lanosterol will not be converted into ergosterol. So this was the main function of any azole. Okay. Fluconazole differs from ketoconazole is, remember, ketoconazole inhibit all steroidal hormone synthesis, Because of this reason, it is unlikely to produce decrease in level of testosterone. So this is the true statement. Okay, it is not active by oral route. False. Remember, fluconazole is given orally. It is more potent inhibitor of drug metabolism. This is a false. Remember, ketoconazole is the more potent CYP inhibitor. I have already told you. It is not effective in cryptococcal meningitis. Remember, both are not effective in Remember, fluconazole is effective against cryptococcal meningitis. Okay. Now, fungicidal drug that can be used orally for the treatment of onychomycosis. Now, the drug of choice for onychomycosis, remember, is terbinafine. And terbinafine, remember, is a fungicidal drug. It's a class of allylamines. Okay? So, it is a overall the drug of choice for. It is given orally. Remember, amphotericin B is only given IV or topically. It cannot be given orally. Okay? Griseofulvin, remember, is not effective against onychomycosis. And it is rather a fungistatic drug. Clotrimazole again is a topical drug. It's an azole. It is also a fungistatic drug. Azoles are fungistatic. Now, all of the following antifungal drug inhibit ergosterol biosynthesis except. Remember, biosynthesis is not inhibited by amphotericin B. Amphotericin B will rather create a pore. Synthesis is inhibited by azoles. Okay, so the answer is azole, fluconazole. Ketoconazole. Amphotericin B is obtained from Streptomyces nodosus. So amphotericin B is obtained from Streptomyces nodosus. From Pimprina, we rather use hemicin. From Norsai, we use nystatin. We have developed nystatin. Okay. Now, topically used antifungal drugs are, the answer is ketoconazole. Yes. Clotrimazole. True. Amphotericin B can also be given topically. Okay. Amphotericin B can also be given topically as an eye drop, etc. So all these three A, B, C are topical drug. So physostigmine, remember, is not an antifungal drug. It is rather an carbamate which increases acetylcholine level. Okay. Now let's move forward. Which of the following anti-metabolites are used as an antifungal drug? Antimetabolites are the fake nucleotide and nucleoside analog. The answer is 5-fluocytosine. So they are fake substrate of DNA synthesis. All can be used for systemic fungal infection except. Remember, griseofulvin is only given for topical fungal infection. Okay? While azoles and other drugs, they are given for both. Okay? Azoles and amphotericin B, they are given for both systemic as well as topical fungal infection. Drug that can be used for treating candida infection except. Remember, the only drug which is not effective in candida was griseofulvin. Which of the following is not true about antifungal drug? Amphotericin B is given parenterally. Only parenterally, yes, because it is not given orally, it's true. Griseofulvin is given orally, true. Cyclopyroxolamine is given for systemic. The answer is false. Remember, it is only a topical drug. So the answer out here will be C. Fluconazole is given orally as well as IV. Yes, we have already discussed. True. Which of the following is a broad spectrum antifungal agents? Now the broad spectrum antifungal agents are azoles. Okay. Azoles are the broad spectrum antifungal, and among the broadest spectrum azole is ketoconazole. Broadest azole is always ketoconazole. It is effective against generally all types of molds and yeast like fungi. All are effective against Taenia versicolor. Now the drug which is not effective against Taenia versicolor, candida and onychomycosis, not effective drug is, that is griseofulvin. Griseofulvin, remember, is not effective against all these three fungal infections. Taenia versicolor, caused by Melassezia furfur, candida and onychomycosis. It is not effective. Griseofulvin is only given, it is only effective against, remember, Taenia. Okay, that is dermatophytes. Remember, Taenia versicolor is not a type of dermatophytes. It is a different Taenia. So this is the only exception among Taenia. Go by the answer, griseofulvin. Now, which of the following antifungal drugs have only topical application? We have already discussed. The answer was clotrimazole. Ketoconazole, fluconazole, they were having both oral एज वेल एज आई वी। केटोकोनाजोल अगेन बोथ ओरल प्लस आई वी, दैट मीन्स सॉरी टॉपिकल, ओरल एज वेल एज टॉपिकल। इट्राकोनाजोल इज ओनली एंड ओनली ओरल, दैट मीन्स सिस्टमिक और आई वी। ओके, सो टॉपिकली इट इज नॉट गिवन। क्लॉट्रिमाजोल इज ओनली एंड ओनली गिवन टॉपिकली, इट हैज नो सिस्टमिक एक्शन। मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ टर्बिनाफीन, टर्बिनाफीन रिमेंबर इट इज एन अलाइलामीन, एंड अलाइलामीन इनहिबिट द कन्वर्जन ऑफ स्क्वालीन इंटू लेनोस्टेरॉल बाय इनहिबिटिंग एन एंजाइम स्क्वालीन इपोक्साइड। ओके, सो द आंसर आउट हेयर विल बी, इट विल इनहिबिट द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ, और इट विल इनहिबिट द सिंथेसिस ऑफ इर्गोस्टेरॉल, बिकॉज लेनोस्टेरॉल विल बी सिंथेसाइज टू इर्गोस्टेरॉल। So the specific answer will be, it will inhibit squalene epoxide, which will inhibit the conversion of squalene into lanosterol. Further, lanosterol will not be converted into ergosterol. Now, treatment of choice for coccidiomycosis, it's a yeast-like fungi. Blindly mark the answer, fluconazole. Okay. Induction of treatment of serious fungal infection. Remember, for any serious fungal infection, we start the treatment with amphotericin B. And we maintain with azoles. Okay, so the answer will be amphotericin B. A 26-year-old male Vikas present to OPD complaining with hair loss, itching on scalp. Physical examination reveals moderate to patchy hair loss, central portion of scalp lesion with ring-like configuration. So ring-like configuration, itching on scalp, okay, with central clearing. Now this is a typical case of tinea capitis. Okay, fungal infection of scalp. Which of the following drug is used for the treatment of this function? Try to find an antifungal drug, terbinafine. The answer is terbinafine, which is an antifungal drug. Okay, now in dermatophytosis, which antifungal drug is not indicated? The answer is the drug which is not given in dermatophytosis or just skin infection is amphotericin B. Remember, amphotericin B is only given as an IV drug for induction of serious fungal infection. Induction of the treatment of serious fungal infection. It is not given for topical skin infection. Okay. Amphotericin B causes deficiency of potassium and magnesium. Okay. It causes hypokalemia. It causes hypomagnesemia, loss of potassium and magnesium into the urine. It's a type of renal tubular acidosis. Now, voriconazole is not effective in, remember, mucormycosis. The only mold where it is not effective is mucormycosis. We have discussed, again, mucormycosis, we have only two azoles. Only two azoles are effective against mucormycosis. That was posaconazole and isavuconazole. Okay, and the drug of choice for mucormycosis was amphotericin B. Now, liposomal amphotericin B word has come. So, advantage over conventional preparation is it is less toxic. Forming liposomal preparation is less toxic, remember. So, the answer will be lesser nephrotoxicity. Okay, lesser nephrotoxicity. Which of the following is caused by amphotericin B? The answer is hypokalemia, loss of potassium. If amphotericin B is administered, the patient should be medicated with. The answer is all of the following. Okay. With NSAIDs, with antihistaminic, yes. With antihistaminics, yes. And with steroids. To prevent allergic or infusion-related reactions. Okay. To prevent infusion related reactions, we have already discussed that part. Okay, now fluconazole is more effective than itraconazole in the following disease. Remember, in yeast like fungi, remember, is cryptococcal meningitis. Okay, a dose limiting toxicity of amphotericin B is, the dose limiting toxicities we have already discussed, that was nephrotoxicity, that is renal tubular acidosis. Okay, now Regarding the lipid or liposomal amphotericin B, the following statement is accurate. So try to find the less effective form. Remember, it may decrease the nephrotoxicity. It may liposomal preparation, remember, makes the amphotericin B less toxic. The most serious adverse effect of ketoconazole is it causes adrenal insufficiency because ketoconazole inhibit all steroidal hormone synthesis in the body. It inhibits steroidal hormone synthesis in the body. I have already told you. For the complete concept why it inhibits, you have to see the complete videos. Now, potassium iodide is useful for the treatment of. Remember, potassium iodide, it's generally sometimes given for sporotrichosis. Okay? It is sometimes given for sporotrichosis. The antifungal drug that amphotericin B is also used for the treatment of which protozoal infection? The answer it is a drug of choice for Kala-Azar or Leishmanial infection. Okay, it is a drug of choice for visceral leishmaniasis caused by Leishmania donovani. Okay, so this is all about antifungal drugs. Hello all, so welcome back to Dr. Ankit Pharmacology series. So now in this section we will be discussing about the last portion of antimicrobial, and in this portion we will be discussing about antihelminthic drugs. Remember, these drugs are effective against three types of helminths. These are cestodes, which are also known as tapeworms, okay, trematodes, which are also known as flukes, and lastly nematodes, which are overall known as roundworms. Okay, they are overall known as roundworms, but specifically roundworm is Ascaris. Okay, so keeping this thing in mind, let's see first the treatment of all helminthic infection. Let's make a summary of all helminthic infection treatment. So, if you try to discuss about all cestode and trematode infection, the overall drug of choice for all cestode and trematode you can see is praziquantel. So, let's talk about first cestode. Praziquantel is the drug of choice for all cestode like Taenia solium, known as pork tapeworm, Taenia solium, Saginata beef tapeworm, Hymenolepis nana, known as dwarf tapeworm, Diphyllobothrium latum, known as fish tapeworm. In case of praziquantel, in these cases you can also use niclosamide, which is a second choice. But remember, in cestode, certain cestode, instead of praziquantel, there are certain exception. The first exception among cestode is NCC, which stand for neurocysticercosis. In neurocysticercosis, the drug of choice is albendazole with corticosteroid. And the second is echinococcus, which causes hydatid cyst or dog tapeworm. The drug of choice again in this cestode, instead of praziquantel, it is rather albendazole. Now let's talk about trematodes, which are also known as flukes. In all flukes, again the drug of choice is praziquantel, like lung fluke, known as paragonomius, schistosomiasis, which is also known as blood fluke or bilharzia. The only exception is Fasciola hepatica. Fasciola hepatica is also known as liver fluke. Here the drug of choice is triclabendazole. Now let's talk about nematodal infection. In all nematodal infection, remember the drug of choice is a very broad spectrum drug, that is albendazole. Mebendazole is less preferred, it is more preferred in pinworm and pork tapeworm. Now albendazole is the drug of choice for Ascariasis, known as roundworm, Nicatarin and Cyclostoma hookworm, Entrobius pinworm, Entrobius vermicularis, Trichuris tricula, that is whipworm, trichinella, that is pock tapeworm. But remember, in pregnancy albendazole is not preferred, it is teratogenic. In pregnancy we prefer to give P for pregnancy, we give parenteral pemoate. Now there is a disease known as cutaneous larva migrans, which is also caused by Encyclostoma or hookworm. Again the drug of choice is albendazole. Now sometimes we prefer to give mebendazole more than albendazole in cases of Entrobius and Trichuris infection, but that is not a rule. Now, the exception among nematodal infection is, these are the exception. Instead of albendazole, in cases of strongyloids, if you can see certain exception in nematode, in cases of strongyloid infection, which causes liver, which causes bladder cancers, which is also known as threadworm, एंड ऑनकोसर्का वॉल्वुलस विच कॉजेस रिवर ब्लाइंडनेस. द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस इज आइवरमेक्टिन. ओके, इन थ्रेड वॉर्म एंड ऑनकोसर्का द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस इज आइवरमेक्टिन. इन फिलेरियल वॉर्म एंड लोआ लोआ द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस इज डीईसी. डीईसी स्टैंड फॉर डाईथाइल कार्बाजपीन, सॉरी डाईथाइल कार्बामजीन. And we also add to it ivermectin because DEC can kill both adult and microfilarial form. Ivermectin only kills microfilarial form. And lastly, dracunculus, which is known as guinea worm, it is the drug of choice is metronidazole. So this is the complete summary of infection. Now let's see what is the mechanism of action of anthelmintic drugs. Some of the drugs, remember, they cause spastic paralysis. The drugs are in the worm. The drugs are praziquantel. It opens calcium channel, and parenteral permeate and levamisole, which opens nicotinic channel. Certain drugs which causes flaccid paralysis, the drug is ivermectin. Remember, ivermectin open glutamate chloride channel. It acts on glutamate. Ivermectin glutamate is very important. Moxidectin and piperazine also causes flaccid paralysis. They open GABA chloride channel. Then we have microtubule inhibitor. They are known as benzimidazole, like albendazole, mebendazole and triclabendazole. So let's talk about the first drug, that is benzimidazole. They are microtubule inhibitor, plus they also inhibit the uptake of glucose. The drugs are albendazole, mebendazole. They are the broad spectrum anti-helminthic drugs. They are, apart from helminthic infection, they are also given in microsporidium, okay, a protozoal infection also. Here the drug of choice is albendazole and fumagillin. Now, triclabendazole is given in fasciola, we have discussed. Now, the good thing about these drugs is that they can kill both adult and larval form of helminthic. They are given orally, but orally they are very less absorbed. Hence, for GIT helminthic infection, they are much more preferred drug because they have a very low oral bioavailability. Remember, they are contraindicated in pregnancy. In pregnancy, we prefer to give parenteral permoate. The main side effect is hypersensitivity, bone marrow suppression, which can lead to agranulocytosis and aplastic anemia. They are hepatotoxic. You have to monitor liver function test. Now, mebendazole is contraindicated in children less than 2 years of age. It is only given for more than 2 years of age. So, the dose of mebendazole in more than 2 years of age is 100 mg. Albendazole is contraindicated in children less than 1 year of age. So, the dose is 1 to 2 years is 200 and more than 200 is 400 mg. Now these are the other miscellaneous drug like levamisole, LMNOP. Levamisole, we have discussed, it causes spastic paralysis. It is only given in ascariasis. It is also have immunostimulant property. Metrifonate, it is given in schistosomia hematobium along with praziquantel because praziquantel was the drug of choice for schistosomia. Niclosamide given in cystoidal infection only. Okay, the dose is 40 mg per day for 21 days for cystoidal infection. Oxamniquine given for schistosomia mansoni along with praziquantel. Parenteral permoate, second line drug for nematode after albendazole, and piperazine is given for ascariasis and enterobius. Now these are the drugs for scabies. So remember, for scabies caused by Sarcoptes scabii, we have certain topical drug, and the only oral drug we have for scabies is ivermectin. Among the topical drug for scabies, the drug of choice is permethrin given as a 5% cream, P for permethrin, P for patch, single application. In pregnancy and small children less than 2 months, we give sulfur in petroleum jelly. Benzene hexachloride, lindane, benzyl benzoate and crotamiton are the other drug. The only oral drug for scabies we have is ivermectin, which is given 200 microgram per kg as a single dose, which can be repeated after 1 week or second week. So this is all about anthelmintics and drug for scabies. Keeping this thing in mind, let's solve the question. So let's talk about the first question. The drug following is not true about mebendazole. We have discussed mebendazole is benzimidazole. It is safe in pregnancy. False. Remember, it is contraindicated in pregnancy. Okay. It is a broad spectrum anthelmintic. True. It has lower systemic bioavailability. We have discussed. It is effective against both larva and adult. Yes, we have already discussed. Now, mebendazole is given in all except, now try to find the answer, schistosomia. Remember, schistosomia, the drug of choice was praziquantel. Okay, praziquantel. It was a type of trematode. In trematodes, we give praziquantel. So, it is given in schisticercosis, yes, ascariasis and trichuris. So the answer is schistosomia. Now drug of choice for tapeworm infection, again we have discussed praziquantel. ओके टेप फॉर्म. डिफरेंस बिटवीन डीईसी एंड आइवरमेक्टिन केसेस ऑफ फिलेरियासिस इज द डीईसी एक्ट अगेंस्ट बोथ माइक्रोफिलेरियन एंड एडल्ट फॉर्म वाइल आइवरमेक्टिन एक्ट्स ऑन एडल्ट फॉर्म ओनली. ओके नाउ क्रस्टिट्स के बाई कॉज बाय सार्कोप्सिस के बाई आइवरमेक्टिन इज यूज टू ट्रीट इट. नाउ आइवरमेक्टिन एक्ट बाय विच न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर आई टोल्ड यू आइवरमेक्टिन ओपन्स ग्लूटामेट क्लोराइड चैनल. नाउ रिमेंबर ग्लूटामेट क्लोराइड चैनल आर वेरी पेक्यूलियर चैनल विच आर ओनली फाउंड इन हेलमेंथिक्स. रिमेंबर इन ह्यूमन ग्लूटामेट ओपन्स नॉट क्लोराइड चैनल इन ह्यूमन्स ग्लूटामेट रैदर ओपन सोडियम चैनल. सो ग्लूटामेट इन ह्यूमन्स इज एन एक्साइटेटरी न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर वाइल इन हेलमेंथिक इट इज एन इनहिबिटरी न्यूरो ट्रांसमीटर. अ वेरी पेक्यूलियर एंड अ न्यू कंसेप्ट. ओके सो द आंसर आइवरमेक्टिन विल कम. यू विल मार्क द आंसर ग्लूटामेट. Anthelminthic which causes flaccid paralysis. I have already told you three drugs which was causing flaccid paralysis. I'll show you that slide again. So this was the slide. Flaccid paralysis, ivermectin, moxidectin and piperazine. IMP, important. So try to find the answer, piperazine. Okay. So piperazine is the answer. Now mebendazole and they are microtubule inhibitor. Okay. Now, which of the following is an immunostimulant? Which antihelminthic is an immunostimulant? The answer is levamisol. Okay. Now, let's write the list of the drugs which are immunostimulant. The list is Libya. These are the drugs which act as an immunostimulant. That is levamisol, intravenous immunoglobulin, BCG vaccine given for superficial bladder cancer, imiquimod, and L-desleukin. This is the complete list of the drugs which act as an immunostimulant. So what does their word, what is their mechanism? You have to subscribe for the complete videos. But the mnemonic is Libya. This is the complete list of immunostimulant. Now drug of choice for guinea worm infestation was metronidazole, which I have already told you. Okay, caused by dracunculus. Okay, dracunculus. So I'll show you that list again. So let's see the treatment. Let's see dracunculus, metronidazole. Okay. So this is the complete list we have already discussed. Now, which of the following drug is not used in scabies? So the answer out here is cyclopyroxamine, olamine. Remember, cyclopyroxolamine was an antifungal drug. While all other drugs are used, benzene hexachloride, permethrin and crotamitone are used in scabies. So I'll just show you the slides of scabies again. So you are seeing crotamitone is written, benzene hexachloride is written, permethrin is also written, while cyclopyroxolamine is not written. What is not true about ivermectin? Now it is the most effective drug for strongyloid infection. The answer for this question is absolutely true. It is the drug of choice for strongyloids and onchocerca. For onchocerca and strongyloids, the drug of choice is ivermectin. It is a drug of choice for onchocerca. The answer is absolutely true. So here in these two conditions, it is a drug of choice, strongyloids and onchocerca. It is also used to treat scabies. Yes, we have already discussed. It is the only oral drug for scabies. Now it is used for pneumocystis infection. No, we haven't discussed. So the answer out here is it is not given for pneumocystis. This is a false statement. Okay. So the not true statement will be D. The anthelminthic drug which is effective against blood fluke, liver and lung fluke and cysticercosis. Now remember, the drug of choice for all cestode and nematode, the flukes and all worms, the answer was praziquantel. Praziquantel was a broad spectrum drug for all fluke. Blood fluke we have already discussed. Okay, that was blood fluke. I'll show you that slide again. Okay, schistosomia, the drug is praziquantel. Okay, lung fluke, yes, paragonimus, the drug of choice is praziquantel. The drug of choice for schistosomia, we have already discussed, was for schistosomia, the drug of choice is praziquantel. It is also known as lung fluke. Okay, lung fluke. Okay, so all fluke, the drug of choice is schistosomia. Now let's move forward. The drug of choice for neurocysticercosis is albendazole, along with corticosteroids. Okay, so this is the treatment of neurocysticercosis. The drug of choice for onchocerca volvulus was ivermectin. Okay, a 25-year female hospitalized with liver cyst due to echinococcus granulosis, and she have to refuse to undergo surgery for the removal of cyst. That is why albendazole was used in for 3 months. Now remember, albendazole, remember, is hepatotoxic drug. I have already told you. And that is why you have to monitor LFT. Albendazole is hepatotoxic, hence you have to monitor liver function test. Okay, you have to monitor liver function test, LFT. Now, which of the following drug causes flaccid paralysis? I think we have already discussed IMP. Okay, that was ivermectin. Okay, piperazine and moxidectin. That was ivermectin, moxidectin and piperazine. These three drugs causes flaccid paralysis. Now this piperazine, remember, is given for ascariasis and enterobius infection, pinworm infection, while ivermectin and moxidectin are given for strongyloid infection and onchocerca infection. So the answer is asking out here is flaccid paralysis as well as ascariasis. So you will go by the answer piperazine. Okay, although ivermectin also causes flaccid paralysis. Now drug of choice for hydatid cyst of liver was albendazole. Okay, caused by echinococcus granulosis. Okay, echinococcus infection. Drug used for echinococcus, again the answer is albendazole. Drug of choice for ascariasis, answer is albendazole. Diethyl carbazepine is used for the drug of choice for filarial worm and Loa Loa, DEC. Diethyl carbazine is given for filarial worm and Loa Loa. So answer is filariasis. Roundworm, best treatment is albendazole. This is the best drug for roundworm. Mebendazole cannot be given for, the answer is onchocerca. Okay, for onchocerca we have discussed, the answer was ivermectin. It is a drug, it is used in ascariasis, enterobius, yes, they are nematodes, hydatid cyst, yes, we have discussed. What is the dose of niclosamide used in tinea saginata infection? The answer was 40 milligram per day for 21 days. It's a very old question. Nowadays, this question is not expected. Okay, so remember, the dose of niclosamide is D. Let's move forward now. Ivermectin is used in the treatment of, think about and tell me, ivermectin was used in the treatment of filarial worm as an add-on drug to DEC. Okay, as an add-on drug to diethyl carbazine. Itself ivermectin is given for strongyloid and onchocerca. Drug of choice for hookworm, albendazole. Okay, albendazole. Drug of choice for neurocysticercosis, albendazole can be used, okay, and praziquantel can also be used, but the overall drug of choice is albendazole. Praziquantel is effective drug to treat all of the following except, the answer was hereditary disease. Okay, the answer was hereditary disease. Here albendazole was the drug of choice. Okay, remember, it is also not given for trichinosis, because trichinosis is caused by nematodal infection. Now the point is, hydrated disease is caused by cystodes. Remember, praziquantel is only effective against cystodes and trematodes. It is not effective against nematode. Hence, if you have to choose among these two options, you will go by the answer trichinosis. You will go by the answer trichinosis. Crusted scabies, we have given ivermectin, and ivermectin act by which neurotransmitter? Remember, glutamate chloride channels. Broad spectrum anthelminthic drugs are albendazole and mebendazole. Okay, ओके, बिकॉज दे आर इफेक्टिव अगेंस्ट ऑल सेस्टोड, ट्रीमाटोड एंड नेमाटोड. पायरेंटल पेमोइट, रिमेंबर, इट इज ओनली इफेक्टिव अगेंस्ट नेमाटोड. प्राजिक्वेंटल इज ओनली इफेक्टिव अगेंस्ट सेस्टोड एंड ट्रेमाटोड. निक्लोसामाइड इज ओनली इफेक्टिव अगेंस्ट सेस्टोड्स. ओके, ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर टेप वॉर्म इन्फेस्टेशन वॉज प्रेजिक्वेंटल. ओके, डीईसी इज प्रेफर्ड ओवर आइवरमेक्टिन इन स्क्रोटल फिलेरियासिस. द रीजन वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड दैट डीईसी किल्स बोथ माइक्रोफिलेरियल एडल्ट एंड लार्वल फॉर्म. दैट इज वाई इट इज मोर इफेक्टिव देन आइवरमेक्टिन. पायरेंटल पैमोइट इज इफेक्टिव अगेंस्ट फॉर, वी विल राइट, इट इज गिवन फॉर एंटरोबियस एज वेल एज एस्केरियासिस. ओनली दीज टू इन्फेक्शन. ओके, ऑल ऑफ द फॉलोइंग कैन बी गिवन फॉर न्यूरोसिस्टिसरकोसिस एक्सेप्ट, वी गिव फॉर न्यूरोसिस्टिसरकोसिस वी डोंट गिव निक्लोसामाइड. ओके, द अदर ड्रग्स कैन बी गिवन एल्बेंडाजोल, मेबेंडाजोल एंड प्रेजिक्वेंटल. द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस इज एल्बेंडाजोल. ऑल ऑफ द फॉलोइंग ड्रग्स आर यूज इन सिस्टिसरकोसिस एक्सेप्ट एल निक्लोसामाइड. रिपीट क्वेश्चन. Which of the following is false regarding mebendazole? It's a broad spectrum, true. It can be given in pregnancy, false. Remember, albendazole and mebendazole are not given in pregnancy. It is effective against both larval and adult form, true. It decreases bioavailability, yes, it's true. Mebendazole is effective against all of the following except, the answer was strongyloid. For strongyloid, we rather use ivermectin. Niclosamide is effective against, remember, all cestode infection. Okay, it is effective against all cestodal infection except dock tapeworm, that is Echinococcus granulosus. Here the drug of choice was albendazole. Now, which of the following are the uses of levamisol? Levamisol is used in escariasis, true, but nowadays we don't use this. It is immunostimulant, true. It causes depolarization, thereby causing spastic paralysis, true. It is immunosuppressant at high dose. The answer is false. I have already told you, levamisol is rather an immunostimulant. It increases the immunity of the body by acting on some types of T cells. Drug used in cysticercosis is, so the answer for this question was cysticercosis, we give praziquantel and albendazole and mebendazole, which is not written out here. Drug of choice for cutaneous larva migraine, it is caused by hookworm, that is encyclostoma. And the drug of choice for hookworm is a nematode, encyclostoma, nematodal infection, blindly marked the answer, albendazole. Now, drug of choice for guinea worm infestation was metronidazole. Okay. Enthelminthics, which act by flaccid paralysis of a worm, we have already discussed IMP, ivermectin, moxidectin and piperazine. Ivermectin is used in the treatment of, the answer is strongyloids. Okay, the answer is strongyloids. But it can also be given in the treatment of filariasis as an add-on drug to DEC. And here it is the drug of choice. So the answer will be both filariasis and strongyloid. So this is all about enthelminthic and antimicrobial. Thank you very much. For the complete video concept, you can subscribe to the videos. Okay.